In today's video, I'm going to teach you how to install Haas stainless access straight tensioners into wood post. We post a ton of really helpful cable railing tutorials here on our YouTube channel, so be sure to hit that subscribe button. The first step in this install will be to grab your hole marking template and mark your end or corner post for the pilot holes that you'll be drilling for your axis straight tensioners. Once your holes are marked, grab your drill and make sure that it's set to its highest speed setting. Using a 1/8 inch bit, drill the pilot holes that are needed for your tensioners at each mark, approximately 2 inches into your post. Go ahead and repeat this process for all the marks on the post. Your axis straight tensioners are composed of 6 different parts. First, we have your stainless steel decking screw, an axis straight receiver, an axis straight eye, an axis turnbuckle stud, a turnbuckle body, and a turnbuckle swage stud. The next step in this install is to mount your axis straight receivers to your post. Start off by securing a T20 star bit into your drill and set your drill to its lowest speed setting. Pass the stainless steel mounting screw through the axis receiver and then drive the screw and receiver into the post. Continue drilling until the receiver fits snug up against the post. Repeat this process for all of your remaining axis straight receivers at the post. Now that your axis straight receivers have been installed at your post, the next step in the process is going to be to pre-assemble the remaining parts of your axis straight tensioners. To start off, you're going to want to grab your turnbuckle body. Your turnbuckle body is right-hand threaded on one side and then left-hand threaded on the other side. The left-hand threaded side of your turnbuckle body is going to be designated by a small indicator line that you see here. Thread your turnbuckle swage stud into the left-handed side of your turnbuckle body. Then thread the turnbuckle stud into the right-handed side of the turnbuckle body. When assembled correctly, the threads of both studs should be barely hidden inside of the turnbuckle body. Lastly, thread the straight eye onto the turnbuckle stud. Repeat this process for all of your remaining axis straight tensioners for the run. Now that your tensioners have been pre-assembled, insert each of them into the axis straight receivers at your post. Grab your cable and then pull the cable hand tight so that all of the slack is out of the cable. With your cable tight, run the cable just over the top of the turnbuckle swage stud and mark the cable at the second measurement line on the stud. Use your cable cutters to cut the cable at the mark that you just made. With your cable trimmed, remove the turnbuckle swage stud from the turnbuckle body while preventing the turnbuckle body from unthreading. Insert the end of your cable into the swage cavity of your turnbuckle swage stud. Make sure that the cable is properly seated in the back of the cavity. Insert the swage stud into the die of your swager and position the die within the swage area on the stud. The swage area is between the opening of the cavity and the small indicator line that you see here. Once your stud is properly aligned in the die, close the handles of the swager to make your first swage. Then, slightly open the handles, rotate the cable about 90 degrees, and then make your second and final swage on the stud. Unscrew your turnbuckle body so that just a few threads on the turnbuckle stud are showing. Then insert the turnbuckle swage stud back into the turnbuckle body and then rotate the turnbuckle body until your axis straight tensioner is hand tight. Go ahead and repeat this entire process for all of the remaining tensioners at the post. Okay, so now that you've got all of your tensioners nice and hand tight, the next step is going to be to actually complete your final tensioning. Now, whenever you do this, you want to make sure that you're following a tensioning sequence. Now, the way that that sequence is going to work is you're going to start with your cable in the middle, then you're going to move to the cable directly above it, and then directly below it. And you're going to continue on with that same sequence throughout all of the rows of cable in your run. And that's going to be the same sequence that you're going to follow regardless of how many cables you have in your run. Okay, so now to start actually tensioning up your cables, you're going to need two tools. You're going to need a vise grip and then also an Allen wrench or a similar type tool. And the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to take your vise grip and you're going to clamp on to the turnbuckle swage stud that your cable is attached to. Now the reason that you're going to do this is to prevent the cable from rotating and twisting, because if the cable does rotate or twist during the tensioning sequence, once your cables are nice and tight and a little bit over time, that cable can actually gradually start to come loose. So you want to make sure that that turnbuckle swage stud is locked in place and your cable does not rotate. So with our turnbuckle swage stud locked in place, we're just going to take our Allen wrench, we're going to insert it through the hole in the turnbuckle body, and all you're really going to do from that standpoint is just rotate your turnbuckle body until your cable reaches the desired tension that you're needing for your run. And it's going to be the exact same procedure for all of the remaining cables for your run. Once you've gone through the entire sequence, check the cables to make sure that they are equally tensioned. If not, tension any cables that may be looser than others. With all of your cables now tensioned, this run is complete. If you feel like the Axis system is right for you, then feel free to click through some of our other Axis component installation videos. If you have any questions about Axis straight tensioners, then drop us a comment below. And if you found this tutorial helpful, then be sure to give it a like. I'm Tyler with Haas Stainless. Thanks for watching.